livestockdodgeboard.com, B&E Waste System, Joy Chiropractic, and Diamond Roofing. When we come back, we'll hear from head coach Gary Thomas. It's all part of the Lewis Ford pregame show here on 1550 AM, the Sports Town, and on the web at conksports.com. It's all part of that Conk Radio Network.
Lewis, United Wireless, it's all the same thing.
Yeah, I know. Did you get that?
Mm-hmm. You want two?
Yeah.
Okay.
Where's my feet going in so hot? Testing 1, 2, 1, 2. All right, there we go. Oakland within five. Uh-huh. There you go. Two. Right before halftime. Oh, no, I've already done that right here.
You got 15.
Okay. Welcome back to the Lewis Ford pregame show here on 1550 AM, the Sports Town, and on the web at conksports.com. Time to visit with Coach Gary Thomas, brought to you by Kelly Hendricks DDS. Kelly Hendricks DDS, wear a smile, you can see 4 miles. And Coach, something a little unusual, Sunday afternoon game on the road, Kansas Wesleyan playing their JV, coming off a big win that we got that really looks like the offense got clicking, got some points on the board last week. Got a little confidence in the team. What's the number one thing you're trying to do here today, other than win?
Just establish consistency. That's going to be the name of the game down the stretch, is us being able to effectively do our job at every position, and this game's no different. We've got to be in the correct gaps on defense, cover the right people, play the scheme the way it's supposed to be played, offensive line, make sure we're gap sound, and make sure we've got bodies on bodies, secure the football, make sure we're going through our progressions correctly, securing the football, all of the very basic things that we preach on a daily basis. Today's a day to just another opportunity to try to get better at all those things.
All righty, last year on the road at Sterling, game got, kind of out of hand early, but your kids, they kept their head, there was no talking out there or whatever, because Kansas Wesleyan's JV, they got a good varsity team, which I ranked number 13 in the nation. It's a good, solid program. Same philosophy today. Do you have to talk with the kids about, if it does get out of hand, this is how you act, this, all that?
Yeah, those are things that you're always, we're not ever out to embarrass anybody. And so, I would hope that, we don't get into a deal where we're in the mode of trying to embarrass anybody. And that's not our goal today. We'll hopefully be in a position to play a lot of bodies and get some guys some experience, which is, this game comes at a good time for us to get some young guys some experience that may have to play down the stretch, and then some of the conference games that'll probably be, pretty close down the stretch. And some of the one possession games that we're accustomed to playing in the Jayhawk Conference. We're here to get better as a football program. We're not here to, try to mock anybody or put anybody in a situation that feel bad about themselves.
All righty, Coach. Everybody healthy today, or is there anybody that you're setting out that, is a little ticked up?
Gary Johnson's out today. He missed about 30 snaps of last week. So hopefully we'll have him back for next week. But other than that, he's the only guy that's out today.
So Mr. McMullen will take his place, correct?
Yeah, Mike McMullen will start at Mike and played a lot of snaps for us last week. He knows the scheme did pretty well, so we shouldn't miss a beat there.
Alrighty, Coach. Offensively, how's everything going? Caden getting better and better, more comfortable?
I think so, yeah. I mean, today will be interesting. Coverage-wise, they do some actually unique things that, again, even if we're matchup-wise, maybe better person for person, schematically, they put you in a bind in certain areas. So, you know, we're still going to have to make sure that we go through our progressions. We're still going to have to protect the quarterback. And, I mean, you don't have to be, the best possible. You know, we don't need Von Miller coming off the edge to be able to sack the quarterback. I mean, if you blow protection, it doesn't matter who he is. If he gets a free shot on the quarterback, you got a chance to get somebody hurt. And so, you know, our challenge today is just going to be, you know, they can still twist and stunt and do all the things that their varsity does. Their scheme is actually very good, and it causes you some problems. They may not be as athletic as us, but, I mean, it's still going to be a challenge to make sure that we count for everybody that we're supposed to count for.
All righty, Coach. Good luck. Thanks for the time, and hope that cold gets better.
Appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Head Coach Gary Thomas here with us on the Lewis Ford pregame show, brought to you by Kelly Hendricks CDS. Kelly Hendricks CDS, where a smile you can see for a mile. We'll be back with your starting lineups. You're listening to the Conk Radio Network.
Two?
Yeah, you can pop me two. Are we going to pump out the national anthem? Are we going to do a national anthem? Okay. Yeah. I don't know. Mic input. There we go. That's a little bit better. Why my levels were so high.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back to the Lewis Ford pregame show. Lewis Ford located right there in Dodge City, Kansas, 200 Military Avenue. Folks, if you're looking for a quality pre-owned car, or hey, maybe you want to treat yourself and you want to go get a brand new nice car, you go down there. Ford has a ton of rebates working right now. 0% financing for 72 months. Go down and see Brad and the boys at Lewis Ford. Phone number 227-3673. Let's go through and take a look at your starting lineups. First up, for the Conk offense, averaging 314 yards a game, 136 of that on the ground, 178 through the air. They're averaging 31 points a game. Leading that offense is going to be the freshman quarterback, Caden Walters. Walters is averaging 176 yards a game, 60% completion percentage. He's got three touchdowns on the season. In the backfield with him, it'll be A.J. Walker, averaging 3.3 yards per carry. He's got a couple of touchdowns and averaging 52 yards a game. Also going to get time in the backfield be Tyler Miner. He's averaging 6.6 yards per carry. Two TDs on the season, averaging 59 yards a game. Miner also averaging 21 yards per reception.
Your wide receiver, it's going to be Watkins and Johnson split out wide. Johnson averaging 3 catches per game, 20-yard average. Watkins averaging 4.5 receptions a game, 6.4-yard average for them. Your slot receiver is going to be Braxton Haley and Douglas Butts. Butts averaging 3.5 catches per game, 11-yard average. Butts with 2 touchdowns on the season. Also going to be in the backfield, see a lot of time, be fullback Chris Messer. He's a sophomore out of Leavenworth. Now anchoring that lineup front is going to be Colby Sunday, 6'1", freshman from Dodge City. On the side, right and left of him, it'll be Sage Young and Gabe Alvarez. Then your tackles are going to be Dunlop and Roy. That's a look at your Conk offense brought to you by Winter Livestock. Winter Livestock, get more buck for your beef. Down and see Brian today. Winter Live with a sale every Wednesday. They've been serving the Southwest Kansas cattlemen since 1936. Take a look at the Coyote defense, Kansas Wesleyan. Guys to watch here. We got Tamati up front. Villalobos will be the backer. Kraft, Kyle, and Mendoza will be in your secondary. And those are some players to watch there. Now when Kansas Wesleyan has the ball, Ainsworth is going to get the nod at quarterback. Cox will be in the backfield with him. Wideouts are going to be Howard, Heck, and Robinson. Now let's take a look at the Conk defense. They're averaging, giving up 206 yards per game. They give up 45 on an average on the ground, 161 through the air. They got 4 quarterback sacks and 3 passes intercepted, giving up 23 points a game. Up front for the Conks, you got Larman, Anderson, and Kelly. Larman with 4.5 tackles a game, 2.5 of those for loss. Kelly with 1 sack and 2.5 tackles for loss. Then the linebacking core, and they're a crew of good ones. You got Gary Johnson, who's out today. Mike McMullen's going to step in his place. On the outside, you're going to have Marquise Blair averaging 11 tackles a game. He's got 7 tackles for a loss, 1 forced fumble, 1 fumble recovery, and 1 interception on this season. On the other side of him, it's going to be O.V. Cleedenard, averaging 4 tackles a game, 1 sack, and 1.5 tackles for loss. Your quarterback's going to be Kerryon Merrill and Michael Young. Michael Young averaging 5 tackles a game. He's got 1 fumble recovery, 2 passes broken up, and 1 block on the season. And then your safeties, you have Jordan Simonot averaging 5.5 tackles a game. He's got 3 tackles for a loss, 1 forced fumble. And on the other side of him, at your strong safety, it'll be Quandraco Statham averaging 8.5 tackles a game, 1 forced fumble, and 1 interception. We're about 3 minutes away from kickoff. That's a look at your starting lineup brought to you by Winter Livestock, serving the Southwest Kansas cattlemen since 1936. We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll look around the NFL. You're listening to the Conk Radio Network.
2?
Yeah, give me 2. Because I think we're going to hit the national anthem fairly quick. You know what? We're probably going to hit that right at 2:44. Watch who wins the kick, the coin flip. There's some cute girls. There you go, Luke. Not for a year. Amanda, did anybody say they heard you on the internet stream last week?
Nope.
Well, you're live going out over the radio.
Hmm.
The just giving you a heads up.
Well, at least I didn't say anything bad.
There you go. Keep it clean.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Take a look what's going on around the NFL, all part of the Lewis Ford pregame show. And the Saints up on the Raiders, 24-19. Chargers up 10 on the Chiefs, 27-17. Bills trailing the Ravens, 13-7. The Bears trailing the Texans, 23-14. And the Packers up on top of the Jaguars, 27-20. Tampa Bay on top of the Falcons, 31-24. Vikings, 25-16 on top of the Tennessee Titans. And the Eagles, 22-10 over the Cleveland Browns. Bengals trail the Jets, 22-20. And that is a look around the NFL. Are we getting set to kick it away? Cox will be kicking off. Good crowd here at Salina. Kansas Wesleyan, beautiful stadium. Renovated it about a year ago and did a nice job. So the Cox will trot out on to the field. Mejia going to set to boot it away. Kansas Wesleyan will have the ball first. Cox will be moving left to right on your home entertainment Zenith Allegro stereo system dial. Wind blowing out of the south today, so Cox kicking into the wind. Back deep will be Whitaker for Kansas Wesleyan and Zach Kyle. Mejia set to tee it up. And the ball rolls off the tee, so somebody's probably going to have to come in and hold it. Mejia will kick off from the 35-yard line. Whitaker and Kyle will stand back at about their own 10-yard line. So Mejia's going to set it up again and have it blow off and coming in to hold it. It's going to be Drake Damon, number 22. Love that last name. So now we are set to get underway. Mejia, left-footed kicker coming up, and we are set to go. Going to be a high end-over-end kick, and it's going to go out of bounds at about the 28-yard line. So Kansas Wesleyan will get good field position to start things off here. As we get set to go. As Ainsworth will have Springsgith in the backfield with him. They'll go three wide receivers. They'll clear out the backfield, flip it out into the flat to Springsgith, and he's going to get knocked out of bounds right there by Michael Young right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. And that's going to bring up second down. And 10 for Kansas Wesleyan. Ball spotted at the 35-yard line. Ainsworth now do a zone read, try to ride it to the right side, but the Cock defense right there to shut it down. Going to be a loss of two on the play. And that's going to bring up third down and 12 for Kansas Wesleyan. Robinson split out wide right. Howard here to the near side. They'll bring a man in motion, going to give him the ball, coming around the corner, and right there is Quadraco Statham with the hammer. Picked up maybe a yard. That's going to bring up fourth down and 11. And Quadraco just shot from that strong safety position. Now Kansas Wesleyan with a quick kick. Good kick. The wind at the back is going to bounce at about the 26. And roll down to the 8-yard line. So that's going to be a 66-yard punt with the wind at their back. And the Conks will start deep in their hole. On their first possession, no score in the ballgame, just underway. Just a little over a minute's gone by. Next action for the Conks. Going to be at home next Saturday, 12 o'clock kickoff. Taking on Ellsworth, Iowa. 1 o'clock kickoff. SID Matt Kinney corrected me. So come on out to Memorial Stadium. We'll go on air about 12:40. So Walker being a backfield with Walters. Conks will start with Tripp split out wide left. Play action pass. Walter's going to keep it himself. Take it up the middle. Bounces off a couple of tacklers and takes it out to about the 13-yard line. And that's going to be a pickup of 5. And that's going to bring up second down and 5 for the Conquistadors. Now, Blakey will check into the ballgame. He'll be lined up at the tight end. Walker in the backfield. Hand off to Walker, trying to get to the outside. Gets across to the 10, breaks a couple of tackles, gets up to the 22, make it the 23-yard line. And that'll be enough for a Conquistador first down. Conk started back. Own 8-yard line. And they pushed it out to the 23, and it all on the ground so far. So you got Johnson split out wide left, Watkins and Butts here to the near side. Kansas Wesleyan jumping off on the far side. That caused Watkins to jump as well. We'll see. Hot laundry on the field. It's going to be against the defense as the outside backer jumped into the neutral zone. So the Conks will have a 1st and 5. Clock runs, 12:10 to go here in the first quarter. No score so far. Conks with their first possession. They're going to go too wide here to the near side. Walters into shotgun. He'll pitch it out left side. Walker gets it. Cuts the corner. It's knocked down after a gain of about 3 far side. On the tackle, number 22, Tariq Brown. And that's going to bring up 2nd down and short for the Conquistadors. It's going to give him 4 on that one. So Butts will check out, Blakey will check in. So Messer and Blakey, 2 fullbacks, they'll check in. Now Butts will check back into the ballgame. Walker, lone tailback. Walters flips it out in the flat, hits Butts, has it at the 37, takes it up near the 43-yard line. That's where he's going to be ran out of bounds. Jordan Kraft on the coverage, and the Conks pick up another 1st down. So now Trenton Hammond will check into the ballgame. They'll go trips to the top side of the field.
Walters, play action pass, flips it out into flats, butts with the catch, but he gets knocked down right away. And on the coverage was Caleb Whitehair. And that's going to bring up second down and 10. For the Conquistadors, as Hammond will check out of the ballgame, and Blakey and Messer will check back in. Messer will line up in the tight end formation. Blakey in the backfield lined up in the slot. Hand off to Walker, big hole up the middle, out across midfield, takes it up to the Kansas Wesleyan 42-yard line. And A.J. Walker just shot through that hole in the Conk offensive line on that left side. Between Sunday and Young had a big hole there. And the Conks into Coyote territory for the first time this afternoon. No score here in the early going. Now the Conks will go diamond formation, trips here to the near side. Walters drops back, flips it out, gets it to Watkins. Watkins breaks one tackle and then gets ran out of bounds at about the 37-yard line. And that's going to be a pickup of 5, and that'll bring up second down and 5. So Blakey will check back into the ballgame. Trenton Hammond to check out. Watkins also going to check out. So the Conks will go. Blakey and Messer, two tight end set. Walker in the backfield. Dubs split out wide. Walters looking out into the flat, throws it, hits Butts. Butts across the 30 and ran out of bounds at about the 25-yard line. That'll be another Conquistador first down. 9:44 to go here in the first quarter. And Walters, perfect so far on completions. I'd like to thank all of our sponsors who bring you Conk football. Lewis Ford, Kelly Hendricks, Winter Livestock, DodgeBoard.com, B&E Waste, Joy Chiropractic, and Diamond Roofing. Here's Walters dropping back. Now he feels the pressure, tucks it up, gets hit, breaks a tackle, gets out of there. Still on his feet, takes it out and going to pick up about 2. All the way down to, let's see, the 18-yard line. So he's going to pick up more than that. Going to pick up about 7. And the Chiefs an extra point away from tying it up. 27-26 right now. So the Conks with a second down, we'll call it a long or a short 3, a long 4. Inside the red zone. Messer will line up in the fullback position. Blakey at tight end. He'll give off to Walker. Walker trying to get to the outside. They got a nice block on the corner, and he'll take it all the way down to the 10-yard line. And the Conks will have a first and goal from the 10. Opening drive here from Gene Bissell Field here in Salina, Kansas. Kansas Wesleyan's varsity, ranked number 13 in the country in AIA. So Blakey will stay at tight end. Messer in at fullback. Low snap. Walters picks it up, gives it off to Walker. Walker juking and jiving, takes it all the way down to about the 2-yard line. Pickup of 8. And that's going to bring up second down and goal from the 2. Under 8 minutes to go here. Opening drive for the Conquistadors. 3 and out. For the Coyotes, here's a handoff to Walker. Gets hit in the backfield and then trots in. Touchdown, Conquistadors. So the Conks with 7:41 to go. Go up 6-0. Pending the extra point, Mejia on. kicking into the wind. High snap. Got it down. Extra point is up and good. And the Conks go up 7-0. We'll take a break. You're listening to the Conk Radio Network.
A minute?
Yeah, go ahead and give me a minute.
Okay.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. It ain't over. Come on, Philly Riv. No, that's fine. It's football. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
Somebody is calling Bonnie, and they're just not giving up.
Is the stream going okay?
I think so.
Okay. Might be the only reason.
Looks like it. Be 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Conks up 7-0. They had a 12-play, 92-yard drive. Used up 6:10 of the clock. 2-yard run by Mr. Walker. Mejia with the extra point. Here's the kickoff. That is Kyle trying to get to the outside, and he's going to get knocked down at about the 25. Drake Damon coming in there making the tackle. Cox, next action, as I said, will be at home at 1 o'clock from Memorial Stadium next Saturday afternoon. And then the following week, we'll be on the road. We'll be at Butler. Butler with a nail-biter last night, winning it 36-34 over Coffeyville. Here's a handoff to the tailback. He'll take it straight ahead, and the Conk defense right there to wrap him up. Coming in there, number 45, back Braxton Larman. And that'll bring up second down. We'll call it 10. So Ainsworth will be lined up in the shotgun. Torian lined up at tailback. Now they'll put Howard in motion. Ainsworth's going to keep it himself. Breaks out of there. Breaks a couple of tackles out across the 40. Down across midfield. And the Conks are going to finally wrap him up and pull him down at the Conk 15-yard line. And that time the Conks just lost containment. And Ainsworth just blew through the line of scrimmage, and now the Coyotes threatening here to tie things up. Springsgeth. Now at quarterback. He'll hand off to the tailback and nothing doing as Shaq Williams just beat his man like a rented mule. Got in there to trip him up. And that's going to bring up second down. We'll call it 10. So Springsgeth in at quarterback. Cox in the backfield with him. They'll go two wide receivers, far side. Springsgeth rolling out, going to throw it towards the end zone, and it's going to be over the head, but we're going to have a pass interference call. That's against, looks like, Michael Young. Cox lead it 7-0 here, 5:24 to go. And here comes the official call. It looked like the pass was uncatchable. And that's going to move Kansas Wesleyan down to the, it's like the 2-yard line. 5:24 to go. Now Ainsworth will check into the ball game for the Coyotes. Robinson And Heck split wide right. Now they're going to put Howard in motion. They're going to do the old option play, and Ainsworth will keep it himself, and no gain on the play. Second down and goal from the two. In there on the tackle is Marquise Blair. So now Ainsworth in the shotgun, Cox in the backfield. They'll put a man in motion, bring him across, get across Cox, and Blair right there going to throw him down for about a two-yard loss. And Marquise just come off that corner. As we've seen so many times already this year, that's going to be a loss of three. Make it third down and goal now from the five. Coyotes, they'll get set now. Howard Robinson split wide right. Ainsworth rolling out, looking to side. Now going to throw it at the last minute, and a catch is made back of the end zone. And that is number 84 Robinson with the touchdown, as Ainsworth keeping his head. Feeling the pressure, just kept rolling out till somebody come uncovered. And Robinson slid in the backside, made the catch, and now the Coyotes with Gossman on for the extra point. Chance to tie it up here with 4:10 to go in the first quarter. And it is blocked, no good. Cox will recover it. That's Marquise Blair coming up as it got blocked. And I didn't see who got their hand on it. So the Cox still lead it 7-6 with 4:10 to go here in the first quarter. You're listening to the Cox Radio Network.
Minute?
Yep. I bet somebody's. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Conks lead it 7-6. Coyotes scored on a six-play, 75-yard drive with took 3:16 off the clock. And now they'll set to boot it away. Gossman set to kick off for the Coyotes. As they're going to bring in Eric Robinson to hold the ball. Robinson, recipient, that 5-yard touchdown pass from Ainsworth. Back deep for the Conks is Butch. He'll pick it up far side, grab it about the 7, bring it out across the 20, breaks a couple of tackles, has a wall here, gets across the 25, now cuts it back, still on his feet at the 25, breaks another tackle at the 40, now down to the 50, and here comes a flag in late, and Butts is going to be knocked down at about the 35-yard line of Kansas Wesleyan. As I don't know, I didn't see the penalty.
Let's see where they're going to mark it. End of the runs at the 35. Flag will come in, or the ball, it'll be marked off where the foul or flag was thrown, and they're standing at about the 48-yard line of the Coyotes. And my technician on site, Luke Deccan, said it was unsportsmanlike conduct against the Conquistadors. And that's going to back him up all the way to the midfield. So it'll go from where the ball was down, 15-yard penalty. So the Conks will start right at midfield, second possession of the ball game. And checking into the backfield with Walters now is going to be Tyler Miner. Messer in at fullback. Kansas Wesleyan showing blitz. Now Thomas will change the play up. 3:52 to go in the first quarter. Conks lead at 7-6. Play clock down to 4. Walters dropping back. Now throws it back across. They get it to the fullback. Messer breaks the tackle at the 45 and falls ahead to the 44-yard line. So a pickup of 6, and that's going to bring up second down. And last year, towards the end of the season, Coach Thomas started working Messer into the offense as the best hands of the fullbacks. Now we got an official's timeout on the field. Up, they're going to have another in sportsmanlike conduct against the Conquistadors. And that's going to back them up all the way to the 40, their own 41-yard line. Braxton Haley will check out of the ball game. So the Conks now will go trips here to the near side. You got Hammond, Butts, and Watkins. Johnson split out wide left. Conks moving left to right. Walters hands off to Miner. Miner with the big hole up the middle. Going to pick up about 7. And that's going to bring up third down. We'll call it 12 for the Conquistadors. Miner straight up the middle there. Now Messer will check back into the ballgame. Hammond will check out for the Conquistadors. So Watkins and Butts here to the near side. Johnson split out wide left. Messer lined up in that slot position at fullback. Walters dropping back to pass, looking over the middle, throws it, and the pass is going to be too high. Intended receiver was Johnson at about the 38, and the Conks will have to punt it away. For the first time this afternoon, with 2:22 to go in the first, they lead at 7-6. So Alex Becker on to punt it away. Becker averaging 41.6 yards per punt. Back deep for the Coyotes is Spencer Howard. Here's an end-over-end kick, going to bounce at about the 30 and roll all the way down to the 18-yard line. So a 34-yard punt into the wind, and the Coyotes will come out, scored on a 6-play, 75-yard drive, their last possession. They trail by 1 with 2:18 to go here in the first quarter. we're going to have a penalty against the Coyotes. It was holding, and that's going to push them back all the way to the 9-yard line. So if the Cock defense can get a stop here, they should end up in good field position. Here's a handoff. Trying to get to the outside. No gain on the play. That was Whitaker. So Whitaker on the end around goes for no gain. And that's going to bring up second down and 10 for the Coyote. Springs Guth. In at quarterback. T. Mateo line up at the fullback position. Now they'll clear the backfield. Springs Guth going to take it himself, breaks a couple of tackles, and then gets knocked down at the 16-yard line. And we got a flag coming in late. Let's see who it's going to be on. Officials still talking. It's going to go against Kansas Wesleyan. Repeat second down. And that's going to back him up. Ocala, the 8-yard line. And the clock will run with a minute 24 to go. Second down, we'll call it 12 for the Coyotes. Springs Guth in the shotgun, looks out, flips it out in the flat, catches made for a gain of about 4 on the coverage. Michael Young. Catch was made by number 84. Number 14. Nick Bornerden. So Springs Guth. They'll get set in the shotgun. They'll go two wide receivers here to the near side. Springs Guth. Going to roll out, now going to go long and throws it away as him and the wide receiver was on different pages. Intended receiver was Whitaker. He broke it in, though, when Springs got thought he was going to go on the fly pattern down the sidelines and Kansas Wesleyan. I have a fourth down and 6. And they'll act like they're going for it. Quick kicked it last time. And this time they get it away. Ball's going to bounce at about the 50. And it's going to take a roll all the way down to the 15-yard line. Miner has to go back and pick it up. Brings it out to the 20. As the seal cuts it up the middle, out across the 40, out to the 50. Miner down to the 40 of the Coyotes. One man to beat it. He's going down the sideline, picks up a block. Touchdown, Conquistadors. 85-yard punt returned for Tyler Miner. And I think Tyler was running out of gas as he hit about the 15-yard line, about stumbled and went in. As he caught it on the far side of the field, brought it all the way back to the near side, takes it in, picked up a big block at about the 15, and then boom, took it on in, and the Conks go up 13-6 with 6 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Mejia on for the extra point. Kick is up. It is good. Conks go up 14-6. We'll take a break. You listen to the Conk Radio Network.
A minute?
Yeah. Going to give me updates around pro football? Okay. Hey, make it 30, Mandana.
Okay. 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Conks take or add to their lead 14-6 on the 85-yard punt return by Tyler Miner. Now with us, an update around the NFL, Luke Deccan. Go ahead, Luke.
Chargers and Chiefs are 27-27 in overtime. Seahawks are beating the Dolphins in the first quarter. Lions and Colts just started tied up at zero. Giants and Cowboys are at zero. Packers beat the Jaguars 27-23. Ravens beat the Bills 13-7. Texans beat the Bears 23-14. Eagles beat the Browns 29-10. Bucks beat the Falcons 31-14. Vikings beat the Titans 25-16. Bengals beat the Jets 23-22. And the Raiders won a nail biter 35-34 in the final seconds over the Saints.
All right, here's the kickoff. Kyle trying to get to the outside, takes it out to the 35. Thank you, Mr. Luke Deccan. We got an injured player down on the field for Kansas Wesleyan. That's number 20, I think, Carlos Mendoza. Holding his right knee there. Trainers out on the field. Raiders.
The Raiders.
Better watch out, boy. Everybody's kind of Cinderella pick this year, Luke.
They went for a two-point conversion at the end of the game to win the game.
That's what it takes. So we'll keep you updated on NFL action. First full Sunday of action in the NFL. And Mr. Mendoza walking off under his own power there. A little limp in that right leg. So we'll start the second quarter. But the Conks lead in 14-6. And the Coyotes will start first and 10 from their own 35-yard line. As Springs get in at quarterback. Get set. Now they'll back off. They're going to change the play at the line of scrimmage. Going to go three wide receivers. Now they're going to put a man in motion. He'll flip it out to him, and the flat catch is made. Far side breaks the tackle. Ball's knocked out of there. Coming up there was O.V. Cledenhard. Knocking the ball out. That is Sissy or Tino. Picks up one. And that's going to bring up second down and 9. They'll flip it out into the flat. Catch is made far side for a gain of about 2 over there on the coverage, Michael Young. So now it's going to bring up third down. We'll call it 6 for the Coyotes. Just underway here in the second quarter. Conks lead it 14-6. So now Springsgith in the shotgun. They're going to roll him out to the right. Looking downfield. Now he's just going to have to get it away. It's coming in there. Was Cledenhard to hurry him up, and the pass goes incomplete. But it looks like we got a flag on the play. Nope. No
flag on the play. It's going to be fourth down. The officials, head linesman, come over there. Talk to the head referee. So now it's fourth down at Will College 6. Ball spotted at their own 39-yard line. Coyotes coming out looking like they're going to go for it. Conks will have one man back shallow. And they're going to go for it. Springs got throws it over the middle, and the pass is incomplete on the coverage for the Conquistadors. Number 20, looked like Rodney Murphy. So the Conks will have great field position here. They'll have it first and 10 at the Coyote 39-yard line.
Quick update here, Damon. The Chiefs just won in overtime over the Chargers.
So it's going to be a better ride home for me now, Luke?
It will be. It will be.
Big grins there. So my man, Phillip Rivers, could not get it done today. Actually, you could probably blame that one on the defense. Staked him to a big lead.
Second half, defensively, they gave up a lot of yards.
So the Conks will start first and 10 from the Coyote 39-yard line. Alters in the backfield. Looking, going to go for it all. Going down the right sideline. Has a man looking for Watkins. And the pass is going to be incomplete, but there is flags all over the place, and let's see who they're going to get. Is it going to be offensive or defensive? On the coverage was Tariq Brown. And I think it's going to go against the Conquistadors' offensive pass interference. Nope, going to be defensive pass interference. And illegal hands to the face against the Conks, so the penalty's offset. So we'll do first down all over again. 13-17 to go here in the second quarter. Johnson in, Butts split out wide left. Murphy gets a handoff, has a hole up the middle, breaks the tackle, takes it up ahead to about the 31-yard line, pickup of 8. And Rodney Murphy, the 5'11 freshman from Wichita Heights, broke his arm in the Shrine Bowl. And this is his first action of the season. And Coach Thomas is really high on the youngster. Now here's Wesley and going to jump offside. That's number 58. That is Jordan Bean. Delray Beach, Florida. He's going to get taken out of the game. Yep, that's 58. That's going to move the Conks ahead 5 yards. That's going to be, or they're going to give him a first and 10. So Murphy in the backfield with Walters. Butts and Johnson split wide left. Watkins blown at the top. Walters picks up the low snap. Now goes for the end zone. Has a man over. Shoots Watkins as he had his man beat. But Caden just put it a little too far out there. Incomplete. Make it second down and 10. Ball spotted at the 26-yard line. Now Jerry Hanks will check into the game. Or now they're going to check out. Going to have Butts and Johnson split wide left. They'll go two tight end set with Blakey and Messer. Murphy in at tailback with Walters. Walters looking out in the flat. That's Butts. Butts with the catch at the 20. Hurdles a man at the 15 and gets ran out of bounds at the 11-yard line. And what an athletic move by Douglas Butts. The Canucks will have a first and 10 at the 11-yard line. Oh, Johnson will check out of the ball game along with Messer. Checking in will be Braxton Haley. And Johnson. So now they're going to stack the receivers far side, and the Canucks are going to call a timeout. 11:58 to go. They lead it 14-6. We'll take a break. You're listening to the Canuck Radio Network.
30 or a minute?
Yeah, give me a minute.
I heard my voice. I was like, oh.
Got 10.
Okay.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Canucks with a first and 10. Ball spotted at the Coyote 11-yard line. They'll go trips. Stacked up, diamond formation, far side. Rodney Murphy in the backfield. Going to get the handoff. Has a hole over right side. Takes it down to the 5. Knocked down at about the 4. Nope, they're going to say he's down at the 5. So it's going to be second down and 4. Pick up a 6 on the carry. So the Canucks now with a stable of running backs. You got Walker, who's more the battering ram. Miner, who's the speedster. And now you got Murphy, who's the slasher. So Walter's in the shotgun. Hand off, give it to Murphy, and that time he gets wrapped up in the backfield. That's going to bring up third down. Going to lose about a yard there, so it's going to be third down. We'll call it 5. Ball spotted at the 6. So Walters in the shotgun. They'll go 2 tight end set. Hank split out wide right. Johnson here to the near side. Offensive line gets set. Walters now has it. They're going to roll him out, going to pitch it out. Murphy there is going to stop, going to reverse field, breaks a couple of tackles out to the 15, still on his feet. Tried to knock him down, going to take it down to the 5 and going to be close. To a first down, no, they're going to say he stepped out at the 4. So Murphy wedges all the way back at the 15, gets it down to the 4, and the Canucks look like they're going to go for it. Or nope, they're going to go for a field goal. Here comes Mejia on. It's going to be about a 21-yarder. As holding for him is going to be Drake Damon. Ball will be spotted at the 11. Mejia gets set. High snap, Damon gets it down, kick is up, dinks off the goalpost, no good. So that time Mejia pushed it to the left. A field goal attempt, no good, so Mejia now 1 of 2 on the season. And Kansas Wesleyan will take over, 1st and 10. the 20-yard line. Kansas Wesleyan, ranked number 13 in NAIA. And JV, it's your shorthanded. Playing much better than the JV team we played last year. So now back on a quarterback will be Ainsworth. They'll go two wide or three wide receivers. They'll put a man in motion. Cox gets a handoff. And Cledenard in there for the tackle along, I think, with Braxton Lorman. So a loss of four. Yeah, we'll call it three. Going to bring up second down. We'll call it 13. Clock runs, 9:20 to go before halftime. Conks lead it 14-6. Ainsworth in the shotgun. Play action pass, now going to roll out, and he's going to get sacked. Marquise Blair and O.V. Cledenard in there. And they're going to lose about five, and that's going to take them all the way back. We'll call it the 13. Loss of four on the play, and that's going to bring up third down. We'll call it 17. And here's a quick kick, and that Conx get a hand on it. Catch is going to be picked up by Quantrenko. Stay them at the 10 and take it in for a touchdown. And the Conx go up 20-0. They tried the quick kick, got a hand on it. And Quantrenko with a heads-up play caught it midair and took it in for the touchdown. Or 20-6. Sorry, I got excited there, Luke. Here, let me turn your mic up. Now you got to watch what you say. So the Conks, they missed the field goal, but it turns out for the best. And Mejia on for the extra point to make it 21-6. High snap. Damon gets it down. Kick is up, and it's good. So with 8:30. Three to go here in the first half. Conks lead it 21-6. We'll be back. You're listening to the Conk Radio Network.
A minute?
Nah, give me 30. I got out late.
Okay.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Conks extend their lead to 21-6 with 8:33 to go here before halftime. Kansas Wesleyan trying a quick kick. Conks partially block it. Quantrenko Statham catches it in midair and trots it in for the touchdown. So the Conks set to boot it away. Going to be Jordan Scarlett. Going to be a sidewinder. Going to bounce it about the 7 and go through the end zone. Be a touchback. And the Coyotes will start 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Conks without middle linebacker Gary Johnson. Scarlett forgot to pick up his tee, ran to run back out and grab it. There we go. Ainsberger in at quarterback. They'll go three wide receivers. Now they're going to split a man out as Ainsworth tries to keep it himself, take it ahead, and going to lose about two. Braxton Larman in on a tackle along with Jermaine Conyers. Those second down, they're going to give him a loss of one, so make it second down and 11. Now they'll go trips here to the near side. Lone receiver to the far side is Robinson. Or excuse me, that's Howard. Top side. Ainsworth dropping back. Here comes the blitz. Far side. Pass is going to be too high. Intended receiver was Howard over there. Stay them with the coverage. And that's going to bring up third down and 11. Pretty decent win here at the field. So now Ainsworth in the shotgun. Trips, diamond formation. Ainsworth's going to keep it himself. Break one tackle, but then Marquise Blair wraps him up. Far side, pickup of one. And that's going to bring up fourth down. We'll call it 9. We'll give him 2 on that one. Ainsworth coming off holding that left arm. Looks like he might have got shaken up on the play. And that's going to bring in Springsguth. And now a timeout by Kansas Wesleyan. We're going to take one with him. You're listening to the Conk Radio Network.
How long?
A minute.
Got it.
Got to get some air. Yipper. Huh? Oh, they did?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Conks lead it 21-6, 7:22 to go. Kansas Wesleyan set to punt it away. Back deep for the Conks. Low snap, but they get it away, and a nice punt into the wind. Rodney Murphy grabs the ball at the 40, breaks a couple tackles, takes it out across midfield, down to the 40, splits some defenders, one man to beat at the 20, touchdown, Rodney Murphy. As wow, Rodney Murphy, wasting no time, getting in to the end zone, and it looks like it might be coming back. The officials talking it over in the end zone. Caught it right at the 40-yard line. So it was a 60-yard return. Well, let's see what the officials come up with. They're going to call it a touchdown. It's going to be good. So it looks like no flag on the play. So the Conks now lead it 27-6. And Murphy with a 60-yard punt return for a touchdown. And Mejia set. Low snap, kick is up, and it is good. So the Conks go up 28-6 with 7:05 to go here in the second quarter. We'll take a break. You're listening to the Conk Radio Network.
Minute?
Yeah.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Conk said to boot it away off a lead at 28-6 with 7:06 to go. In the first half coming up, we're going to have the B&E Waste Systems halftime report. Scarlett, kick it high, end over end one. That'll go through the end zone, and it'll be a touchback. The Coyotes will start first and 10 from their own 25-yard line. And Springsguth will be your quarterback as Ainsworth went into the locker room holding his left wrist. So the Coyotes are going to go two wide receivers far side of the field. Conks showing blitz as Blair cheating up on that right side. Now they'll change the play from the sideline. They'll put a man in motion. That's Whitaker. They'll bring him across. They'll give him the ball. Whitaker breaks a couple of tackles, almost squirted through that line and got into that secondary. But got held up at the 30. So a gain of 5, and now we got flags everywhere. Some of the Kansas Wesleyan players and some of the Cox getting in a scuffle. Checking in the ball game is going to be Adrian Castelli for the Conquistadors. We'll see what the flag is. Personal foul against Kansas Wesleyan. That'll be second down. And that's going to back them up 15, so that's going to take them all the way back to their own 15-yard line. So they're going to have a second down, and we'll call it 25. Or 20, excuse me. So second down and 20 for the Coyotes. Springsguth. They'll put Whitaker in motion. They give it off to the tailback, but nothing doing and wrapping him up's number 44, Desmond Kelly. Going to be a loss of about 3 on the play. And now make it third down. And we'll call it 23. So third and 23, they'll go two wide receivers to the top side of the field. Springsguth going to roll out, looking back across the field, gets knocked down in the end zone by Desmond Kelly. Pass is incomplete, and that'll bring up fourth down and 23, and the Coyotes will have to punt it away. 5:49 to go before halftime. So on the kick it or punt it away is going to be Jay Gossman. He'll stand in his own end zone about 4 yards deep. Gossman gets the punt off and this time shanks it into the wind and it goes out of bounds. And I think they're going to put it down at about the 15-yard line.
So that punt's going to go 3 yards. So the Cox will get it first and 10 at the Coyote 15-yard line. With 5:46 to go before half. Walters will be alone in the backfield, trips to the far side. Too wide here to the near side. Damon and Watkins, here's the snap. Walters looking for it in the end zone. Braxton Haley with the touchdown. As that time, Haley saw the opening in the end zone and just camped out there, and Walters put it right on the money. And the Conks now up 34-6 with 5:40 to go, and we got a flag far side. It's going to be offsides defense. It'll be declined. And the touchdown is good, so the 15-yard reception from Walters to Haley stands, and Mejia on for the extra point. Kick is up, and it is good. So 35-6 with 5:40 to go. We'll take a break. You're listening to Conk Radio Network.
Minute.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Conks lead it 35-6. Jordan Scarlett set to boot it away. This one's going to be returnable. It's going to bounce at about the 15. Going to be picked up by the back man. That's Whitaker, and he's going to get knocked down right away. Coming up there, making a tackle for the Conquistadors. Number 26, Adam El-Sultani. El-Sultani, the freshman linebacker from Manhattan, Kansas. Coyotes will go. Four wide receivers. Springsguth in the backfield. All alone. Has Torian back up fullback in with him. Here comes the pressure off the corner. Now Springsgut's going to throw it out of bounds, incomplete. And he gets hit by Marquise Blair. So that's going to bring up second down and 10 for the Conquistadors. Clock stopped with 5 minutes and 30 seconds to go before that always entertaining B&E Waste Systems halftime report. Now they'll bring a man in motion. Here's a handoff, and coming up there's That is number 11 for the Conquistadors, Dakota Anderson, the backup free safety. So now it's third down, we'll call it 9. I was heck on the carry. Springs got in the shotgun. They'll back it off, check over to the sidelines. They'll change the play up. Cox in the backfield will shift to the left. He'll run out in the flat. Springsguth now going to put it down the middle. Pass is going to be knocked away by Quandraco Statham, and Springsguth had his receiver. That was Robinson, had Quandraco beat. And the ball hung up in the air, and Drake was able to catch up to it. Highland, they end up moving to 2-1 on the season. They win earlier today, 52-2. So Anderson will check out of the ball game. Going back deep for the Conks will be Drake Damon. He'll stand on his own 40-yard line. Gossman on to punt it away. And that's going to be a delay of game, and that's going to back the Coyotes up five more. So now fourth down, we'll call it 14. Good snap. Gussman gets it away. It might have got partially blocked. Going to bounce it about the 31. Damon will let it go. And that's where the Conks are going to take over. So the Conks will start first and 10. They're going to mark it down at 38. 39-yard line. So Walters will trot back out. Going to clear out the backfield. Trips here to the near side. Dubs to the top of the field. Braxton Haley. Trenton Hammond will line up in the slot. Watkins and Johnson split out wide. Now they'll flip it out in the backfield. Catch, pass is going to be dropped, excuse me. Intended receiver was Trenton Hammond. Looking for it out in the flat. Couldn't hang on to it. Hammond, 6'2", 205-pound sophomore. And he'll check out of the ballgame. He'll go over and talk to Coach Gunnar Twiner. So now trips here to the near side. Walters drops back, looking out to his right, throws it, has a man. Catch is going to be made and then dropped as Drake Damon got hit far side. I think that's number 46, Sissy Ortino. And so now third down and 10 for the Conks. Hammond will check in. For the Conks, empty backfield for Walters. Haley and Hammond will line up here in the slot. Here's Walters. Going to have to roll out to his right, looking across the middle, throws it, and a catch is going to be made. Diving catch, and that is Braxton Haley, and that'll move the chains. And Walters was running out of real estate, far side. And threw it back across his body and threw a perfect strike to Haley. Clock's runs with 3:49 to go before half. Conks up 35-6. Walters now flips it out far side to get it to Watkins. Makes one man miss. Dancing around at the 20. Bringing it back. Picks up a block from Walters. Down to the 25. now stops and finally knocked down at the 22. So after all that running, the Conks pick up about four. Looks like we got maybe another flag on the field. Let's see what the call is, far side. 3:29 to go, Conks up 35-6. So the penalties against the Conk offense, and that's going to back him up and make it first down. Call it 17. Walters lone in the backfield. Conks with trips far side. And now we got a timeout on the field. We're going to take one with them. Conks lead it 35-6. We'll take a break. You're listening to the Conk Radio Network.
Minute?
Give me 30.
Okay.
Three, two, one. Welcome back. Conks lead it 35-6 with 3:07 to go before halftime. Walters alone in the backfield. They'll go trips to the far side. You got Johnson and Haley here to the near side. Hammond and Watkins split wide right. Drake Damon in the slot. Walters looking down the middle. Hits Watkins. Makes the catch at the 20. And that's going to be a 13-yard gain, and that's going to bring it second down, and we'll call it four for the Conquistadors. And Watkins is down on the field. Trainer for Kansas Wesleyan. Out to check him out. As now he's up. And a walk off under his own power. So Walker and Messer are going to check into the ball game. So Hanks will split wide right. You got Haley lined up in the slot. They're going to run the pitch. Are going to give it off to Messer. Little shovel pass ahead. Conks are going to have the first down. And And the clock runs with 2:32 to go. So first and 10 for the Conquistadors. Ball spotted at the 13-yard line. Alters in the shotgun. And it off to Walker. Walker dancing around the line. Butts through the hole. Breaks a tackle and falls ahead to close to a touchdown. Let's see where they're going to mark him down. They're going to put him down at about the 2-yard line. So the Conks will have a first and goal from the 2. Walker in the backfield. Blakey lined up in the slot. Alters pitching back to Walker. Walker, the head of steam, will trot into the end zone. Touchdown, Conquistadors, 41-6. And Mejia on for the extra point. Drake Damon to hold. Kick is up, and it's good. Conks go up, 42-6, minute 39 to go. We'll step away. You're listening to Conk Radio Network.
Minute?
Yeah. Can you hear me down there, Luke? Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Conks lead it 42-6, minute 39 to go. Scarlett kicks it off. This one's going to go into the end zone, and the Coyotes will have it first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Coyotes on their second possession went 75 yards, six plays to 251. That's where they got 6 points. Extra point was partially blocked. Springsguth on at quarterback, hands off over the left side is Sissy Ortino. So a gain of 2 there, make it second down and 8. So second down and 8 for the Coyotes. Clock runs coming up on the minute mark. Two wide receivers here to the near side. Hand off to Sissy Ortino, and he'll take it over that left side and maybe pick up a yard. And that's going to bring up third down. We'll call it 7. Coming up is the B&E Waste Systems halftime report. Springsguth line up in the shotgun. 15 seconds ago, play clock down to 10. They'll put a man in motion, bring him across. Hand off to the tailback, Cicciardino. And no gain on the play, and that's going to bring up fourth down with time has expired. But we got a flag on the play. Now let's see the officials. Going to be holding against Kansas Wesleyan. And penalty is going to be declined. That's the end of the first half. Conks lead it 42-6. We're going to take a break. You're listening to the Conk Radio Network.
Two.
Hey, give me 30.
Oh, I gotta 30, go. Okay.
Yeah. Hey, Luke, have you got a copy? Where's my boy at? Hey, Luke. Luke, can you hear me?
Any more time?
Yeah, give me more. Bring it back.
Okay.
Okay.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back to the B&E Waste Systems Halftime Report as Luke Degen going down and going to get Coach Thomas here. Coach Thomas talking to the coaches out on the field before he comes over and gets a hold of us here as he heads in at halftime. Conks lead it 42-6. It's the B&E Waste Systems Halftime Report. B&E Waste Systems, a locally owned and operated trash removal service in the Dodge City area. No job too big or too small. For B&E Waste Systems, handle weekly pickups, one-time drop-offs, you name it. If it has to do with trash, B&E can't handle it. So we go down. Luke's going to get Coach Thomas on the phone here. Luke, go ahead and turn your ear monitor on there. As Coach Thomas, he'll break away. He's still talking to his coaches there. He'll come over and find you. So the Conks gave up 75-yard drive, and that is the only points and really the only time Kansas Wesleyan has got into Conk territory. As we got a shortened halftime here with about 8 minutes here. They're going to take a short half, and they're going to have a running clock here in the second half. So time should speed up a little bit as we wait. Coach Thomas still out talking to his assistants there. Don't forget, next week we'll be at home taking on Ellsworth, Iowa. Kickoff of that game is going to be at 1 o'clock. And then the following week, we're going to be on the road. We'll be at Butler to take on the Grizzlies, who won a nail-biter. And then it will be on the road to Indy, then home against Iowa Western. Then we'll be on the road to Fort Scott, and then we'll have two games at home. We'll have Garden City and Coffeyville, and then we'll have a bye week there, and then we'll finish out their season on the road at Hutchison November 12th. And Garden City gang will be homecoming October 22nd. So the Conks
trying to get some bugs worked out on the offensive side of the ball. It's starting 9 freshmen offensively. Give you an update around the NFL. As Coach Thomas still talking to his assistants. And Luke standing down there. Luke, can you hear me okay? As Broncos has won earlier Thursday night, 21-20. Green Bay wins today over Jacksonville, 27-23. Texans knock off the Bears, 23-14. Ravens, 13-7. Chargers lose in overtime to the Chiefs, 33-27. Ravens over the Bills, 13-7, as I said earlier. 35-34, Raiders knock off the Saints. Bengals win a nail-biter against the Jets, 23-22. 29-10, the Eagles over the Browns, 25-16. Vikings over the Titans. Buccaneers win 31-24. And games underway. Miami tied with Seattle, 3-3. Dallas on top of the Giants, and we go down to Coach Thomas. And Coach Thomas, I hope the audio's a little bit better. And are you seeing out of your offense what you wanted to? Hey, can you turn your mic on down there, Coach? Sorry about that. As there we go. Now I think we got you. Coach Thomas with us on the field. Coach, I still can't hear you down there. Okay, we're going to have to trash it. Some battery might be out. Is a green light on down there? Green light's on, and now we're having problems. Oh, well, Coach, we tried. Coming back up. Thomas is having some technical difficulties. As we lead it 42-6, 3:47 to go. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll look at your halftime stats. You're listening to the Cock Radio Network.
How long?
Give me 2 now.
Got it.
Why are we in this little box? What's it? No, it's okay. I just asked. No, I'm talking this. Okay. All right, what's wrong with my ding? Okay, we got it going out, and we got it going in to number 4. Right? Right. Why in the heck is my mic not working? Gonna be nice. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. It's technical difficulties. Don't know quite what happened down there, but oh well. Let's take a look at your halftime stats. Conx, 12 first downs. Kansas Wesleyan just two in the ball game. Net yards rushing, Conx at 94, Kansas Wesleyan at 58. Rushing attempts, Kansas Wesleyan 19, Conx at 15. Passing, Walters 11 of 15. Kansas Wesleyan 5 of 12. Total offensive yards, 194 for the Conquistadors, 73 for Kansas Wesleyan. Average game per play, Conx was almost 7 yards per play, Kansas Wesleyan at 2. Leading rusher for the Conx, Walker with 67 yards, Murphy with 15. As I said, Walters 11 of 15 for exactly 100 yards and one TD. Receiving Butts, 4 catches, 39 yards. Haley with 2 catches and a touchdown in the ball game. Watkins, 3 catches, and Messer with 2. Becker, 1 punt for 34 yards. And punt returns, Statham, 1 return for 17 yards and a touchdown. Tyler Miner, 1 return for 84 yards and a touchdown. And Murphy, 1 for 59 yards and a touchdown. And Mejia is 0-for-1 in field goals. All-purpose yards, Butts with 98 yards for the Conx. Leading tackler for the Conx is Larman with 4 tackles. 1 tackle for a loss. Marquise Blair with 3 tackles for a loss and 1 sack in the first half. And Blair, the only Conx with a sack so far in the ball game. And Luke, there you go. Now you know why radio is so awesome, because it's a live beast and you never know when it's going to work.
I don't know what happened down there, but that mic was on, so I guess maybe we'll
Did
catch
you have it orange or was it green?
It was green.
Was it green? I don't know what happened. Maybe I didn't.
Maybe we'll catch up with Coach after the game.
Because I tell you, I don't know.
I heard it there. Quick NFL update if you want to hear real quick. Damon,
okay.
I can go for that. The Seahawks are up on the Dolphins at half. The Lions are beating the Colts 14-3, and the Cowboys are up 9-7. Those are the only 3 NFL games going on right at this moment.
Cowboys let the Dak Prescott era begin.
We'll see how that goes for you guys there, Damon.
Luke, it's like I tell all you Chiefs fans, win a Super Bowl in my lifetime. So the Conx will be set to kick it away here. Going to go a running clock here in the second half, which should speed things up. Conx will be kicking off, I think, with the wind at their back. Or no, maybe. Nope, the Conx will be receiving to start things off here in the second half. Back deep will be Johnson for the Conquistadors, along with Quandraco Statham. Blakey will be the up man. And Gossman set to punt it away. Set to receive. And here's the kickoff. The wind's going to catch it up. It's going to be Johnson grabs it far side, brings it out across the 30, out across midfield to the 50. Still on his feet, runs over one would-be tackler, and then finally gets knocked out of bounds.
at about, let's see, they're going to mark him out at the 28-yard line. So the Cox will start in excellent field position. And we'll see if Jordan Becker comes out, or Alex Becker, excuse me, comes out here in second half, and that's exactly who's going to get the nod to run the offense. As Becker in the shotgun, Murphy will be in the backfield with him. Murphy gets a handoff, heads up the middle. Or excuse me, that is Tyler Miner. So Miner picks up about five. And that's going to bring up second down and five for the Conquistadors. Conks, second team offensive line in there. Here's Becker with it now, throws it out in the flat, catch is made far side. Going to be close to a first down. And the catch, looks like it's going to be Jerry Hanks. So now third down, we'll call it one. As Messer going to check out, and checking in will be Trenton Hammond. Luca Vila will be split out wide. Here's Becker, hands off. That is Miner. Miner with a hole over left side, breaks one tackle and trots into the end zone. Touchdown, Tyler Miner. And now make it 48-6. And the Cox extend the lead. And Mejia on for the extra point. So the Conks go 28 yards as the extra point is up, and it is no good wide left. So it now 48-6. We'll step away. You're listening to the Conk Radio Network.
How long?
A minute. Well, you can talk to me. You can put that down. We're in commercial. What's up? Just keep it clean.
Will they do running clock second half?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I get it. Okay.
What time is it? Ooh. We might get home by 9 o'clock. Huh? Two and a half. Yeah, because it's 4:43. So we get out of here at 6. Oh, yeah,
five,
you got, guys
four,
have to shower.
3, 2, 1.
Welcome back. Jordan Scarlett set to boot it away. 10:54 to go in the third quarter. Conks up 48-6. Ball blows off the tee. As we was coming in, Luke, we noticed, as I've never been here to this campus before, but what a great little campus and athletic complex they have here at Kansas Wesleyan.
It is beautiful here. You know, I was commenting on their practice field, even looks
just pretty. Right next to the football field here. Soccer field over there. You got the tennis courts there. Here's a kick. Scarlett booms it. It's going to be grabbed by Heck at the 5-yard line. Heck bringing it out. Takes it up to across the 20 and going to get knocked down at about the 23 on the tackle for the Conks. Adam Al-Sultani, his second big tackle on special teams this afternoon. So Springs got going to go the rest of the way at quarterback is Ainsworth. Goes in. Looked like a wrist injury. The Conks now with their second team defense in. Pass over into flats, going to be caught far side. Catch is made. Nice move over there. That's number 87, I think, Howard. And Howard showing his quickness there. Catches a deflected pass. Makes a Conk defender miss. And they'll pick up the first down. Ball moved up to the 34-yard line. So Springsgeth in the shotgun. They'll check over to the sideline. 48-6, Conks on top. Play action pass, Springsgeth looking around all day to throw it. Now he's going to have to just get rid of it and flip it out in the flat, and I think that's going to be intentional grounding as there was not a receiver in the area. Well, let's see. The officials talking it over here. It's going to be defensive holding against Michael Young. So Young and Heck going at it. And that's going to move the ball out to the 44-yard line. First and 10 for the Coyotes. Springgut now, play action pass, flips it out in the flat. Pass is dropped. Coming up there on the coverage is Derek Pauley, a 5'10 freshman from Conway Springs, Kansas. And that'll bring up second down. Now they'll bring Heck in motion. Young will follow him. They give Heck the handoff, and he gets knocked down right at the line of scrimmage. Sonny Brown in there on the tackle. And now make it second down and 10. For the Coyotes, they lead it 48-6. Now we got, it's like another penalty. Was it a face mask? That gives the Coyotes a first down at the Conk 41-yard line. Springs got dropping back to pass, looking long, looking down the sideline, has a receiver, catch is made over the shoulder by Howard, number 87, and it's going to be first and goal from the 10. And Springsgeth put that one right on the money, and Howard right over the shoulder going out of bounds, makes the catch. And now we'll see if the Conk second team can keep the Coyotes out of the end zone. Springsgeth now looking over the middle. Catch is going to be made at the 14. Touchdown, Coyotes. So just like that, Bona Orden with the catch. And it's now 48-12, pinning an extra point. Coyotes will get lined up. Clock runs. As I said, we're going to have a running clock here in the second half, 48-12. Snap, kick is up, and the Conks get another block on the extra point, and the ball scrambled for, but it's going to be called dead. So the Conks block two extra points. We'll take a break. And that was Michael Young on the block, and I think that's his second block of the season. You're listening to the Conk Radio Network.
30?
Yeah. Give me a minute.
Okay.
So what's your name? What? Fedrick. What's your last name? Peter? Pitter? P-I-T-T-E-R? Harry Pitter. Where are you from? Oh, you're a long ways away from home. How about Nick Chubb yesterday? Georgia Tech fan? Huh? Oh, really? Gotta love Chubb, though, yesterday.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Coyotes set to boot it away. Back deep for the Conquistadors is Drake Damon along with Zach Strong. Going to be a high end-over-end kick. It's going to be picked by Damon up at the 30-yard line. Breaks a couple of tackles, trying to get to the outside. Cuts it up out across the 50 and going to be tackled at the 45-yard line of the Coyotes. And, boy, you get that kickoff up in the wind, and it just almost stops it. Conks leading it 48-12. To thank everybody here, Kansas Wesleyan, making us feel at home. Great facilities. Good little crowd here this afternoon watching the ball game. Gets in attendance around 200-300. So Becker will go in the shotgun. Conks will go trips wide. It's like Murphy in it. Tailback. He'll get the handoff. Heads over the left side. Has a hole. Breaks it. Almost gets knocked down, but stays on his feet and takes it all the way down to the 25-yard line. So a pickup of 20. Going to mark him down at the 24. So first and 10 for the Conquistadors. And I think you saw a little bit what Coach Thomas is so excited about. His freshman balance he has running. Now Becker's going to flip it out in the flat. Catch is going to be made over here. Taken down. That is Zach Strawn. Take it down to the 15. Going to be close to another Conquistador first down. Going to be about a half a yard short. So Messer's going to check into the ballgame. 30 seconds left here in the third quarter. Clock running down. I'll have to get this play clock off, about 4 seconds differential. So Hageman in at fullback now, number 36, not Messer. Here's a handoff to Murphy, sees a hole up the middle, breaks the tackle, takes it down to about the 6 or 7 yard line. And the Conks will have a first and goal, and that's going to do it for the end of the third quarter. Conks lead it 48-12. We'll be back. You're listening to the Conk Radio Network.
A minute?
Yeah.
Okay.
Told you he was going to get out of here quick. Yeah, we're gonna have. So you'll have to go down rather quickly to get Coach at the end of the game.
Okay.
Put that monitor on, and then just talk to me through that mic. Like if I talk to you, just turn that mic on and I'll talk to you. But just have it shut off, and then when you hear me in the headpiece, and just turn it on and I'll talk to you down there. And, yeah, you can go out and stand on the sidelines here, dude.
Okay.
Yeah. You go out there, man. You're part of the action. Go onto the field. Welcome back. Conks with a first down and goal. Ball's going to be spotted at the 6-yard line. Alex Becker on at quarterback. Conks are going to go 3 wide. They'll go 2 to the top, 1 here to the near side. Rodney Murphy in at tailback. Hagerman will line up at fullback. Here's a handoff. Becker's going to roll out. They're going to flip it to Hagerman. Hagerman makes the catch and going to get knocked down at about the 4-yard line. So Hagerman getting in on the action to back up fullback as Blakey and Messer get most of the calls there. Hagerman, a freshman from Andale, Kansas. Now Murphy in at tailback. Becker hands off. Murphy heads over the left side, breaks a couple of tackles, takes it down. Looks like he's going to be stopped just short of the goal line. And that's going to bring up 3rd down and goal. And Murphy lost his shoe. Trying to get it on and does. Knocks out the 3rd and goal. The ball just resting right outside the goal line. Conks will get to the line, 7 on the play clock. Becker in the shotgun, going to flip it, throw it, catch is going to be made. Nope. Say incomplete in the end zone, but we got a flag on the play. Let's see what the call is. False start against the Conquistadors, and that's going to back them up 5, and that's going to put it 3rd down and goal from the 5 instead of having it right on the goal line. So that's going to back him up. So Avila will be lined up wide to the left. Up, they're going to decline the penalty. And now it's going to be 4th down and goal from the 1. Becker in the shotgun. Give it off to Murphy. Gets hit in the backfield. Falls in. And let's see. I think they're going to be stopped short. Yes, he is. So the Coyote defense stopped the Conks on 4th and goal from the 1-foot line. And Coach Langren and Coach Thomas talking to his offense over there and is not pleased, it doesn't look like. So now, the Coyotes will have 1st and 10 from their own 1. Here's a handoff, and that is
going to be the tailback, Cicciardino. He's going to be pick up about five, and that's going to bring up second down and five for the Coyotes. So Springsgith going to shotgun. Play action pass, looking down the sideline. Catch is going to be made. Let's see. They wrestle for it. Who's got it? As they say, it's going to be Coyote football. As the catch was made by number 83, Brandon Lowe, on the coverage. As number 48, Derek Pauley. So a first down for the Coyotes. Spring dropping back, looking out in the flat. Catch is made at the Conk 48-yard line. Number 86, Lee. First time we called his number today. So another first down by the Coyotes. Whitaker now going motion. Springgut's going to keep it himself, take it ahead and pick up about three. They get second down and seven. Tackle's going to be made by Cunningham, far side. Defensive end. So second down, we'll call it seven. Under 10 minutes to go in the ballgame. Conks lead it 48-12. McCoy and Lee split out wide left. Whitaker to the top. Now here's Springs got going for it. Look, as a man down there, and I think we're going to have a penalty as Pauley got turned around and nothing he could do but interfere with McCoy. And that's going to be a 15-yard penalty. So that's going to take him from the 44 down to the 29-yard line. And Springsgith starting to pick on Derek Pauley. So first and 10 for the Coyotes at the Conk 29-yard line. Put a man in motion. Handoff is made, and the Conk defense coming up there. As number nine, Jordan Simonot, making the tackle. They tried the end around. Going to lose maybe a yard on that one. And Hayden Davis now in at quarterback for Kansas Wesleyan. Wesley now with four wide receivers, balance set. Now here's the pressure. Hayden Davis is going to have to tuck it up, and then he's going to get knocked down. Sonny Brown over there to make the tackle. Going to be a loss of about three, and that's going to bring up third down. We'll call it 13. Conks lead it 48-12. Now Springsgith. Check into the ballgame. Davis will check out. Davis from Holly, Colorado. So third down and 13. Two wide receivers to the top side of the field. Here comes the blitz by the Conks. But we got Laundrie on the field and play stop. Let's see what the call is going to be. I think it's going to be false start.
against Kansas Wesleyan, and that's exactly what it is. So that'll back him up 5, and that'll make it down in about 19. So third down and 19 for the Coyotes. 6:15 to go, 48-12. Springsguth in the shotgun. Four wide receivers going to roll him out to the right, flips it out in the flat. Catch is going to be made, but pass is too low. Lee with the catch far side. And that'll bring up fourth down and 16 for the Coyotes. Coming up, we're going to have the Joy Chiropractic post-game wrap-up show. Dr. Jason Joy, chiropractor, yours truly. Here's the pass down the sidelines, and they're going to get the conks for face guard and far side. And they're going to whistle Al Saltani. Saltani looked like he had to play covered good, but might have been some hand checking earlier. That's going to be an automatic first down for the Coyotes. 4:45 to go. So that'll give him first and 10, ball at the 21-yard line. Put a man in motion. Whitaker make the handoff to him. They give it to the tailback. Nothing doing, maybe a gain of one. On the carry is Cicciardino. And make it second down and 9. 4 minutes to go in the ballgame. Conks lead it. Next action is going to be next Saturday at Memorial Stadium. Kickoff at 1 o'clock. So the Coyotes going to go 3 wide. They'll bring Whitaker across. They give it off to the tailback. He'll pick up about 7. Cicciardino with the carry. That's going to be third down. We'll call it 2 for the Coyotes. All spotted at the 13-yard line. Got to go just inside the 11. Davis in at quarterback. Going to lose the ball. Fumbles it. Loose on the turf. But Davis falls back on it, and that's going to push him back all the way to the 21-yard line. So now it's going to be fourth down and 10 for the Coyotes. Make it 11. Clock runs with 2:35 to go. So Davis, third string quarterback, into the ballgame. Play action pass. Looks, throws it. Ball up in the air. It's going to be incomplete. And Davis got hit right as he let go of it. Sonny Brown in there. Along with number 23, Adrian Castelli. And the Coyotes will turn it over on downs. And now under 2 minutes to go here before the end of the game. It
And Luke, can you hear me down there? It's my man on the sidelines, Luke Deccan. Here's a handoff. Rodney Murphy breaks a couple of tackles, cuts it back, takes it across the 30, and going to be down at the 35. And now coming up on the 1 minute mark. Here's a handoff to Murphy again. Takes it out the left side. Breaks a tackle. Still on his feet. Down to the 50, 45. And finally knocked down at the Coyote 40, 39-yard line. And now, under 30 seconds to play here in the ballgame. As Becker comes up to the line. Hands off to Murphy again, hole up the middle, puts his head down, runs over one tackler, puts his head down, runs over another, and goes all the way down to the 18-yard line, and that's probably going to do it. As Rodney Murphy giving us a little bit of taste of maybe what we're going to see the rest of the season, and that's going to do it. The Conks win it 48-12. We'll take a break. You're listening to the Conk Radio Network.
Two?
Yeah. Hey, Luke, can you hear me? Luke, is that light green? I can't hear you. Hey, change the battery.